Can a company patent the genes inside the human body, including yours? That's the question the U.S. Supreme Court takes up Monday.
This case involves Myriad Genetics, a Utah biotechnology company that discovered two genes associated with breast cancer and ovarian cancer and patented the discovery.
So what that patent means is that Myriad technically owns those genes called BRCA1 and BRCA2, and it's the only company that can test for them, essentially creating a monopoly, which is an area now causing controversy. The thinking here, at least in part, a company that has no competition has no reason to keep prices low. According to the American Civil Liberties Union, one organization that filed the lawsuit against Myriad, testing for the cancer genes cost about $3,000, and many times it's not covered by insurance. The ACLU claims not only does the patent place ownership on nature, but also restricts further scientific research and possible discoveries by other companies. However, Myriad argues that although the genes are created in nature, their patents are valid because of the extraction process, which does not occur in the natural world. And a lawyer representing Myriad tells NBC News it's only fair for the company to keep the patent after all the time it put into the discovery of the genes, arguing countless companies and investors have risked billions of dollars to research and develop advances under this promise of stable patent protection. Although this certainly thrust the battle over gene patents into a public spotlight, it's nothing new in the U.S. Since the discovery of the gene around 1900, the U.S. Patent Office has granted more than 3,000 gene patents, including one similar to the BRCAs. According to the New York Times, this recent lawsuit comes after a case last year, Mayo Collaborative Services versus Prometheus Laboratories. In that case, the Supreme Court ruled that while the promise of exclusive rights provides monetary incentives that lead to creation, invention, and discovery, that very exclusivity can impede the flow of information that might permit, indeed spur, invention. So what might come of this new case? An analyst on Bloomberg voices his speculations.
The pattern with the Supreme Court is that they are more skeptical of patents. Twice in the last few years, the Supreme Court has considered the scope of what can be patented, and both times they restricted it at least a little bit.
For Newsia, Megan Murphy, multiple sources, a broader view.